मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रियंका श्रीवास्तव, मैथ्स टीचर ऑफ एनएलके ग्रुप ऑफ स्कूल्स, वेलकम यू ऑल टू अटेंड द मैथ्स सेशन। चिल्ड्रन, एज यू नो, वी यूज हिंदू अरेबिक न्यूमरल्स फॉर काउंटिंग, बट इन रोमन एम्पायर दे यूज्ड रोमन न्यूमरल्स फॉर काउंटिंग नंबर्स। सो टुडे लेट्स रिवाइज एंड अंडरस्टैंड मोर अबाउट रोमन न्यूमरल्स।
Now children, there are seven basic symbols to write Roman numerals. These symbols and their Hindu Arabic values are as follows: I is equal to 1, V is equal to 5, X is equal to 10, L is equal to 50, C is equal to 100, D is equal to 500 and M is equal to 1000. Now here's some special features of Roman numerals. No symbol for zero, so we can't represent zero by Roman numerals. Second, no place value system. Third, it uses rules of addition and subtraction of the above numbers to write other numbers. Now children, there are some basic rules to write Roman numerals. Rule 1, repetition of a Roman numerals means addition. Children, look at the example. Here, I. We know that individually I is equal to 1. So, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. If we look at the second example, here, x. And we know individually x is equal to 10. So, 10 plus 10 plus 10 is equal to 30. But here you have to note that only I, X, C and M means 1, 10, 100 and 1000 can be repeated. Second, V, L and D means 5, 50 and 500 cannot be repeated. Third, no symbol can be repeated more than 3 times. So, I, X, C, M can be repeated up to 3 times. Now rule 2, addition rule. When a smaller number is written on the right of a larger number, the smaller number is added to the larger number. If you look at the example, here xi, and children look at the example, here I is smaller than x and written after x. So, according to rule 2, 10 plus 1 is equal to 11. If we look at the second example, here also V is smaller than X and written after X. So, according to rule, 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. Now, look at the third example, here XXV. So, 10 plus 10 plus 5 all together gives 25. Now move to rule third, and this is called subtraction rule. When a smaller number is written on the left of a larger number, the smaller number is subtracted from the larger number. Children, look at the example. Here, I is smaller than V and written before V. So we will subtract 1 from 5. So 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. If we look at the second example, here XL. X is smaller than L and written on the left of a larger number. So we will subtract 10 from 50. So 50 minus 10 is equal to 40. Look at the third example, here IX. Here I is smaller than X and written on the left of the X. So, we will subtract I from X means 1 from 10. So, 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Now children, here you have to note that V, L and D never be subtracted. Children, if we look at this example, here V is added to X. And if we look at this example, V subtracts I. So, V, L and D never be subtracted. Second, I can be subtracted from V and X only. Look at this example. Here, I is subtracted from X and here, I is subtracted from V. Now third, X can be subtracted from L and C only. So here, X is subtracted from L. Now rule 4. If a number is placed between two numbers of greater value, it is subtracted from the numbers on the right. Children, look at the example. Here, X, I, V. And I is placed between two numbers of greater value. So, firstly, we will subtract I from V. So, 5 minus 1 gives 4. Then add 4 to X. X is stand for 10. So, 10 plus 4 is equal to 14. Similarly, in example 2, here X, I, X. Here, I is placed between two numbers of greater value. So, firstly, we will subtract I from X. That is 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Then add 9 to X. So, 10 plus 9 is equal to 19. Thank you, children. I hope you all are understood today's topic. Okay, children. Bye-bye. Take care.